the response from the Kremlin has been uncompromising. The foreign ministry described Theresa May's accusation against Moscow as a circus show. Its boss Sergei Lavrov said there was no proof the poison used against Sergei Skripal came from Russia. And the embassy in London promised an equal and opposite reaction to any UK measures. Beneath this bluster, however, is cool calculation. Skripal and his daughter Yulia were poisoned in Salisbury with a Moscow-made military nerve agent, developed during the 1970s and 1980s during the Cold War. Whoever wanted to murder him might have used a subtler weapon. Instead, his assassins picked Novichok. How it was deployed remains unclear. One former employee of the Russian Special Services said nerve agents were used only if the goal was to draw attention. This is a very dirty method. There's a risk of contaminating other people, which creates additional difficulties, he told the Kommersant newspaper, adding, there are far more delicate methods that professionals use. In other words, Novichok was a gruesome calling card. As those who organized the hit must have known, the trail goes directly back to Moscow. The incident even took place down the road from Porton Down, the government's military research base, which swiftly tested and identified the toxin. All of which means Vladimir Putin and his FSB spy agency have probably sought to engineer a confrontation with the UK. Why now? There are many theories. The most obvious answer is Sunday's presidential election. True, Putin is guaranteed to win. He has scarcely bothered campaigning. But the Kremlin remains worried about turnout, amid widespread voter apathy and calls from Alexei Navalny, Russia's most prominent opposition politician, to boycott the vote. The authorities want the poll to look authentic, even if it isn't. On Tuesday, Donald Trump broke his silence about Russia's probable role in the poisoning of Sergei Skripal. Photograph Evan Vucci, up over the next few days, state TV channels will pump out this message: Moscow is again the victim of a Western conspiracy. Russia under siege is a favorite Kremlin theme. Conflicts with the West can bear some fruit. Putin has maintained a bump in his nominal popularity rating after his annexation of Crimea, despite Western condemnation and sanctions. The wave of patriotism that followed also split the Russian opposition. So a row with London can do Putin no harm, especially among voters who share his uncompromising nationalist worldview and his smoldering sense of victimhood. One former senior Foreign Office advisor said it was a mistake to assume that Skripal's spy work for MI6 triggered the decision to poison him in Salisbury. Skripal was merely the instrument. The real target was the UK, he said. I don't think it was about Skripal. It was a geopolitical intervention. The advisor added Moscow's goal is to demonstrate the UK's weakness and isolation and to drive a wedge between us and other countries. The Kremlin understands how to make these sorts of interventions at just below the level that will trigger a serious collective reaction against them. If May fails to react adequately, she would appear weak. If she tries to fight back against Russia, she would discover the limits of collective solidarity, the advisor suggested. There are other theories. Grigol Shkartashvili, best known for writing detective novels under the pen name Boris Akunin, suggested Putin was betting on a British retaliation that would drive wealthy and prominent Russians out of London. The immunity of Russian émigrés and families of wealthy businessmen and officials was one of the weak points of the regime, he wrote, and forcing them out would be useful and beneficial for Putin. Timeline: September 1978. In one of the most chilling episodes of the Cold War, the Bulgarian dissident was poisoned with a specially adapted umbrella on Waterloo Bridge. As he waited for a bus, Markov felt a sharp prick in his leg. The opposition activist, who was an irritant to the communist government of Bulgaria, died 3 days later. A deadly pellet containing ricin was found in his skin. His unknown assassin is thought to have been from the secret services in Bulgaria. November 2006, the fatal poisoning of the former FSB officer sparked an international incident. Litvinenko fell ill after drinking tea laced with radioactive polonium. He met his killers in a bar of the Millennium Hotel in Mayfair. The pair were Andrei Lugovoy, a former KGB officer turned businessman, who is now a deputy in Russia's State Duma, and Dmitry Kovtun, a childhood friend of Lugovoy's from a Soviet military family. Putin denied all involvement and refused to extradite either of the killers. March 2012, the exiled Russian banker survived an attempt on his life as he got out of a cab in East London. He was shot four times with a silenced pistol. He had been involved in a bitter dispute.